Well, Sam Botkin, man, you're the founder of GroupMuse.com. And I'll tell you, I mean, it's all about classical music. You're a classical music guy. You just ran into me. You're younger than both my sons. So yeah, I thought old people like me were into classical music. But in talking to you before we started this interview, man, you convinced me. I got to get to these classical music things you're doing. And,
and really, keep in mind that Franz Schubert, one of the greatest artistic geniuses of human history, he was dead by the time he was 31 years old.
Ooh.
So it's like to say, and like this is some of the most stratospherically great stuff that's ever been created. I mean, he was not an old guy. He never got the chance to be an old guy. Humanity would be better had he gotten the chance to be an old guy, but alas, we went not so lucky.
Well, I'm not over yet. I figure I have 20, 30 more years yet, so I got a lot more to do. And but you're putting on now, your motive is to really encourage people to appreciate classical music. And for the uninitiated like me, I mean, I listen to 3 minutes or whatever, and I get bored. But you really explained to me why this is important. And but more important than that you created these settings around the country where people could go, like in people's homes, people put parties together, almost like parties, social parties, yeah. And younger people are going to them instead of bars,
yeah.
And into these social settings in someone's apartment or home, and a group of like semi-professional classical music people come and play.
Yep.
And you're kicking $10 for them, but you have a wonderful evening, right?
That's exactly how it works. There's something uniquely warm and sort of convivial about the atmosphere, and I think that's because everyone is sharing a great masterwork of art together. So you show up at a group muse and you don't know anyone there, and there's still this sort of early party dynamic, ice needs to be broken, all that sort of stuff. But then you all come together and you sit on the floor, and we do floor seating, and you're like bunched in together like sardines in a can, and you collectively experience one of the shattering masterpieces of human history. And the thing is that these pieces, I mean, a lot of the time they're fun and exciting. Some of the time they take us to emotional places that are unfamiliar, and we go there together. I mean, sometimes not just unfamiliar, sometimes they're just uncomfortable, like a Shostakovich string quartet can be scary and despair-inducing, and we're all doing it together. And then when intermission comes around, and especially after the music is done, the volume of conversation in the room just goes through the roof, because everyone has just shared this thing together, and we've all had this, like I say, a collective experience. And that's really when the group muse magic sets in, when we've all experienced something together and we just feel so alive.
Well, it's like Burning Man, though, with clothes on, right?
It's like Burning Man with clothes on and no fire, or
right.
Less fire.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's no fire.
But I mean, and the evening you mentioned, it's only 45 minutes of music, and really they're usually like 2-3 hour, you know, parties or social things that people are interacting with. And another interesting thing, that these are not, you know, diehard classical music lovers that are doing. I mean, I'm not going to be in there with some PhD physics or PhD in musicology, you know, kind of thing.
Certainly not. No, most of the people there are not regular classical music listeners, and yet they keep coming back week after week. I mean, it's this wild thing. For a lot of folks, this was the first string quartet they'd ever seen.
Wow.
And now they've seen more classical, like performed classical music than any other form of performed art. You know, in the last 2 months, they see 10 in the over the course of 2 months, and whether or not they identify themselves as such yet, they are classical music listeners.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, I mean, to me, what's great about this, I mean, you are so passionate about the art form that instead of, you know, like advocating for subsidies to keep more classical music people, you're really going out and educating more people about how cool classical music is and how important it is to life if we just listen.
Yeah,
we just don't listen, do we?
Yeah. No, it's interesting, and the issue of education, I think, is really interesting, because education is sort of, it's a funny term. It's kind of, it has implications, you know, and so I try not to style this as, we try not to style this as an educational
it's
experience.
It's like broccoli if it's education, right?
Exactly, it's like broccoli. So it's like, yes, you do learn about the range of human emotions, and you learn about history and how forms of expression have changed over time, but the idea is that it's enjoyable and it's beautiful, and there is this human need, this basic low-level human need to experience beauty and to experience these works collectively together.
But see, your passion like that makes it, you know, a good teacher doesn't make you feel like you're being educated, right?
Well, I guess perhaps that's true.
I mean, think of the good teachers you had in college, the ones that were really more entertaining than educated.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Just engrossing, you're engrossed and you're engaged, and that's the bottom line.
So that's what you're doing, the average man. And I'm looking at the pictures of these things that you have around the country now. They're really young people, millennials mostly, getting together on a Friday, Saturday night, you know, instead of going to that, you know, crowded, smoky, loud bar.
I mean, we see, the thing is, it's about classical music missionary work, for sure. It's about making the form more accessible. It's about demystifying it. But it's like maybe even more about community building.
I think it's about
bringing people together to share something beautiful and significant and profound.
Yeah.
And it's also about posing this question to folks, you know, how do we spend our time together?
Yeah.
How do we congregate? Are we congregating in positive and healthy ways? I mean, you know, there have been, you know, over the past few years, there have been a lot of questions raised about how young people are spending their time together. You know, the scene at universities is just scary for a lot of people.
Right.
And so the question is there a better way to spend time?
Yeah.
Can we find a better way to come together? And I think we are trying to answer that question.
Yeah. Well, then, you've answered it. Yeah, right. And you say that everybody gets in there, whether it's a small apartment, so anybody could put one of these things on. They just sign up to your site, right? And they say, I want to have one. And you find them musicians if they don't know any, right?
Oh, for sure. Yeah. I mean, it's a system. It's all automated now.
Yeah,
so
all automated. So it's like Airbnb or something like that, or crowd surfing or whatever. And it's all there for you. And if you want to attend one, you just go to your site. I mean, that's groupmuse.com. And you sign up, and so you vent it, and some people will have anybody. Some people want you to give them more information before they come to you over the house. But it's usually not an issue. And the only thing that you may want to give is like, $10 for the help pay for the musicians, and they're the only ones to get money, right?
Yeah.
You're not even getting money out of this.
No, we're not. We do not make money. We do not make money off of community group uses. We're hoping to make money by bringing the experience into the office world, and we've made a few sales, and we've sensed a lot of interest in that and the potential there.
Well, because you know that'd be great in the lunchroom. You know, I mean
exactly. I mean, that's the whole idea, and I think that it's not just that we need to make money, and we do.
Right.
Also, it would be rendering a really valuable service to society.
Right. Now, and I think it's something like you have, you know, the groups get together, you know, companies to have, you know, what are they, you know, they go Outward Bound and stuff like this to group together, you know.
Exactly.
We could do it around classical music. What's better than that? To be nice to each other instead of trying to beat the hell out of each other.
That's exactly the idea.
Well, that's just wonderful. You've only been at it a year or two, and you're getting written up all over. You were in the Wall Street Journal recently and everything.
Yeah, that was a big moment.
But it's so easy to do, isn't it? I mean, you just do go to, you know, groupmuse.com, you sign up, find what's, you know, in your
I mean, it takes 30 seconds to sign up. It takes 30 seconds to RSVP. And in fact, hosting in some ways is even easier because you literally do not need to leave your house. And
if you would like
to stay in your pajamas and not put your shoes on, like it's kind of like magical. You go online, you press the host button. Within 90 seconds, you've filled out the necessary form.
Yeah.
And then at the preordained time, musicians, very fine musicians show up. Wonderful
they
people show
up.
A great masterwork of art is recreated in your living room, and then
you meet a whole bunch of new people too that
you
never
knew. Right.
That are nice because they're not coming to a gladiator match. You know, they're coming.
There's definitely a
wonderful. Well, I think it takes young people like you to see the needs that we really, you know, are missing in our society and to provide them for us. So I'm glad you're there, Sam, doing this stuff, because old farts like me would never think of this stuff. So. We need it, and people go to groupmuse, groupmuse.com. I flunked English in college, so I spell everything for everybody. Just if they're like me. I'm not as smart as you.
Well,
wonderful. Thank you again, Sam, and Groupmuse is something we need. Thank you. Bye now.